Hello everyone, Lakeisha McKinnon. I'm still reading prayers from Kimberly Daniels' prayer book, Prayers That Bring Change. I love this prayer book and I just wanted to make this video so someone else can take advantage of these awesome prayers. But this is the Posterity Prayer based on 1 Chronicles 29, and it's in section 3, Prayers for Spiritual Warfare. But Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for the vision to build your house. Jesus, I acknowledge you as the head of the house. I bless your holy name for the prosperity and favor that you have released unto us. Now, out of that prosperity, I receive the posterity that has been willingly released from my spiritual leader. I promise that I will be the one who will continue to build the vision of God with my inheritance. I draw from the anointing that is on my leader's life, and I receive the double portion. I receive the generational blessing of the mantle that is falling upon me now. I receive command authority that will cause a command blessing to follow me wherever I go and rest heavy among all that I pursue. Let the blessings, favor, wisdom, prosperity, posterity, and understanding of the head be my portion. Let my children's children partake of this inheritance also. The lines of the Spirit have fallen upon me and my children in pleasant places, and I declare that we have a good heritage. I promise to be a good steward of my inheritance and guardian of my heritage. My spiritual bloodline is contagiously prosperous. Let my offering unto God be from a holy and blameless heart. Because of my willing obedience and commitment, let the people of God rejoice. Father, I bless and adore you. Greatness, power, glory, victory, and majesty are yours forever. I acknowledge that the heavens and earth are yours. Yours is the kingdom. Yours is to be exalted as head over all. Both riches and honor come from you. You reign over all. Your hands are power and might. With your hands, you will make your people great and give strength to all. Thank you, Lord, for the attributes that your name denotes. I ask myself, who am I that I should retain strength and be able to give unto the Lord willingly? The answer of my heart is that all things come from you. When I give unto you, it is literally from your own hand. I am a stranger and a sojourner, and I wear the word loosely. My days on the earth are like a shadow, and I have no hope or expectation of remaining forever. I take no pleasure in the temporal. My hope is in that which is eternal. Lord, let my heart continue to be tried by your blessedness of your presence and your power of your holy name. Let me continue to abide in uprightness in your heart. This is my portion by which I can continue to willingly give and be humble, recipient of the flow of your holy abundance. Lord, as a true son, may I acquire and maintain a blameless heart to keep your commandments, testimonies, and statutes, to continue to do what is required of me to finish your vision. I thank you that you have already made provision. Amen.